Hello everybody, and welcome back once again to Super Metroid Eris 2012. I almost forgot what heck I was playing there. That's not a good sign for my memory. Anyway, back in here to collect the super missile that we can now charge a giant spark for underwater because of our chosen armor. So I'm going to try to collect this item here. Out left corner of the door, basically, so. And, oh, wow, that worked out better than I thought it was going to. I enjoy when that happens. It's like a happy accident. So I'm going back through these rooms to collect some more items I may have missed, or that I know I've missed, or couldn't get before, because I'm trying to collect everything. So, we'll end up seeing how that goes. At the very least, I'm hoping for a really high number. I'd still prefer to collect everything. If I don't collect everything, I'd probably make a bonus video or something about that. I know there's something over here. Oh yes, the spot in the wall. I actually really, really like how that's hidden. Because it looks like it's part of the wall. It fits in with the scenery just perfectly. And it's not difficult or anything. It's just a fake wall. And so that's something I like to see in hacks. I mean, when you're in this room, this missile here, if you have wave beam and you hit it or lay a power bomb or something and see it, you'd be confused how to get it because you would end up bombing and finding the crumble blocks, but otherwise, you're thinking, what? How in the world did I get that? And it turns out it's just a fake wall. That's. I really like how that is because it's not hard to do or find necessarily, but it kind of is hard to find still. I think there's a good balance between difficulty of finding the item and how easy it actually is to collect. I like how that worked out with that particular item. Got to hear Lettuce Leaf, and I actually don't want to go this way. I don't think. Just run through these guys. I have a suit now. Back through to the Metroid place, hatchery, whatever you want to call it. I'm actually starting to kind of run out of ideas where the items are. I know some have been changed and all that. I know there's like 7 more super missiles hitting the world somewhere. Actually, I think I may just head to the final area right now. I have everything I need to get there. And then I'll just collect what items I know are left that I know of from that point. And I like how the final area in this game is set up. It's set up a lot like the original Super Metroid, which had a really good setup for it, too. Because in both these, you can see the access point to the final area. And you very quickly learn early on. I think they're both, like, right. You can get to them both right after bombs. But you can get to them really early on. And the original was the part with the green pirates where you had a blue door or a missile door, so you're kind of curious about the missile door. So you go back there and you find the statue room. And so then you have a goal. You know there's going to be these four bosses somewhere you have to fight. And that was especially evident if you played the original Metroid with the statues of Kraid and Ridley and that. So now you know there's 4 bosses, and there's some floaty sack and a shrimp in there now. So that gives you a goal to work toward. Then Eris here, it's a bit different, but if you try to use the Chozo statue thing without having all the artifacts. I think it tells you how many artifacts you have left to collect before it will move you down to the last area. And I think that's a really good design choice and setup, because it gives the player something to work toward, because they can find it really early, but they don't necessarily have to. But being able to find it early, and if they do, it gives them the goal to work toward, and they're not completely lost throughout the whole thing, like a lot of people are in generally most hacks. Generally, like a lot of the early hacks, you know, you have to find Mother Brain somewhere. You kind of had an idea about that, but something with more work put into it like this, or like with the statue room in the original, is very, very close to the beginning. It gives you a goal and something to work toward, which I think helps keep the player focused on what they have to do. And especially with this, since you're not fighting bosses, you're collecting artifacts, it tells you what this new thing you have to do is. So I think that's a very good design choice to do. Of course, not everyone has the ability to make a statue like in Eris here or in Redesign, where it tells you how much guardians you have to disarm or how much many artifacts you have to collect. It's not quite like that. I mean, it's not something you could just do from smile, right click, say, do this. That's not gonna happen, so. It does take some coding, which is unfortunately beyond me. So anyway, here's the room. It's blocked off by speed boost blocks now. Actually, that kind of ruins the whole thing I was talking about, because now you can't get to it that early. You have to wait till speed booster to find what's back here. And here's something I want to try. I've heard about this. You lay a bomb before you get caught in the hand. The bomb goes off while you're caught in it. It should explode you out of the hand to do like a little bomb jump after this guy's done walking with you, so I want to see if that works. But yeah, putting speed boost blocks kind of ruins that now. But, well, I guess that's something he wanted to do. And there we go. A little bounce from the statue hand. And here are your four artifacts. It's made to look like your artifacts are right there, but those are four other artifacts. And this is one of the fan favorite rooms here. It's another one of these rooms, but. And they're really neat in how they're designed and set up with the scrolling. And it's a little. I've done this, and it's a little bit tricky to get it worked around your brain, what needs to go in what layer and where. But it does provide a really interesting visual effect. And this blocked off. Hi, Metroid. This must be the room. Oh, there's speedboost blocks too. Okay, I do know there's a room with Metroids, with like hidden Metroids or something, that I want to destroy all the Metroids in to get to the special added on area. That's where my brother did his little thing. So, that may be the room there. It's like a door they unlock or something. So. And that did not make it. So yeah, I do know you have to defeat all the Metroids, and there's like some hidden section or something with them in it. And that didn't work either. Let's try. try this again. Maybe. Oh, good. Hi, Metroid. So yeah, this is probably the room. A little morph tunnel there. Oh, wow, that was stupid. I should have jumped the Metroid over. And there's a locked door, so this is probably the room. So I've got to find Metroids and destroy them. And you need power bombs for this. I know that. Because there's like these two Metroids and maybe another that are behind walls completely, so you have to have enough power bombs to destroy them. So it takes 3 per Metroid, so far you have to at least have 6 power bombs to do this. And there's obviously a morph path down there, but hi, Metroid. Yes. Break them there. Oh, that was stupid. Why did I do that? Get off me. Thank you. Okay, so that, I don't think that was the secret. That was kind of obvious. Yeah, that definitely wasn't it. Because I was told it's not really obvious. Oh, hey, there's a power bomb hiding down there too. So there's gotta be something else hanging around here. Oh, here we go. Now an item. A missile hanging out back here. Oh, I guess I'm done with this. Oh, there's stuff down here. Oh, hey, Metroid. Yes, I hear it down there. There's gotta be a way to get to that power bomb, though. It kinda looks like there should be a tunnel right there. Oh, well. So yes, I see this guy back here. Does he need like 9 or 10 power bombs, I guess? I guess dying if you collect one up here, wherever. However you do it. Which is not being very obvious right now. There's gotta be a way to get to this thing somewhere. So I know there's a way to get to that. And that was a complete failure. I cannot believe there's no morph tunnel through there. Anything? Oh, there we go. There we go, that's a bit better. There we go, another power bomb. Okay, that was a big ordeal for finding that. So, the door should be open now, I believe. And actually, with that, I think we'll leave off this bonus area for the next video, so you're gonna have to wait and see what's all in store for us back there. So, hopefully you enjoyed the video, and hopefully we'll see you for that one.